everyone, thank you for coming tonight. I guess you didn't get enough entertainment at the fair this week, did you? So we have some more free entertainment here at the library. We have Jerry Barlow here. He's coming all the way from Colorado. And he is a Celtic fingerstyle guitarist, storyteller, and humorist. So very excited to have him here. He will be warming up a little bit, and then I will let him take it over.
Good evening. Nice to be with you here this evening. Thank you for coming by. I love library concerts because I think library audiences are the best audiences you can ever hope to have. They're certainly the most intelligent and well-behaved. There's hardly ever a fight, right? Right, Robin? Is it? And it's free. That's good, too. It's free. $5 to get out, I think, is how we do it.
Yeah.
That's how we make them. So, play Celtic music, music from the British Isles, basically places like Ireland, Scotland, England, and Wales. And part of my love affair with the music is the history of the music. So many of these songs have been around for centuries. And whenever I play them, I'm always thinking about who must have played this and under what circumstances. You know, some of these songs were the last pieces of music men heard before they went into battle. And so on and so forth. So, thought I'd start with a tune here called The Chase. Now, I'm not sure what this is speaking to, but it does conjure up the imagery for me of a chase. So I think of Irish or Scottish freedom fighters in the Celtic force somewhere, dealing with the English dragoons. This is called The Chase. And also I'm using this a bit of tap guitar, which is to say I tap on the neck of the guitar to make some of the sounds. And it gives the guitar a little bit more of a percussive quality, sort of like a hammered dulcimer, if you will. So try a little bit before you. Thank you. I'll do this. This is an old Irish tune that came over, not quite sure when, but it's been here for quite some time. And what happens with a lot of these tunes as they travel through time and space is we change the titles, and then we start thinking that this is our tune or something like that. This particular tune is called The Little Beggar Man, a little Irish tune. And over here, sometimes we call it The Red-Haired Boy. And it's fun to sing. My only problem with it is there are a lot of words and not very many places to take a breath, so you kind of take a very deep breath at the beginning of the tune and try to squeeze it out over about a 2-minute period. It gets really uncomfortable towards the end. Every year, thousands of people die singing this stupid song, so wish me well. Do you want to dance? You can dance if you would like. That also goes for anybody else, too. Here, if you want to. Could be. We might wind up on MTV if we're not careful. From the Libyan down to Saku, and I go by the name of old Johnny Dew. The mother trains are going, I'm so begging is the best way. The man's tired, he can sit him down to rest. Big four with some forgotten loving as I do. Then to cut around the corner with this old thing to do. Rup da di di up, rup da do, and rup da di di up, di back do. Rup da rup da rup di do, and rup da di di up, di back do. Over the road, and back, and back. Over the field, and the great heavy sack. Holes in my shoes, and my toes, pick and bruise. Sing a skiddly rinky doo. I must be going to bed before it's getting late at night. The fire's all right, and out goes the light. Now you know the story of my old rig and do. Good night, God be with you, Mojana dear. Rum-da-diddy-a-rum-da-do-da-rum-da-diddy-a-dee-da-do. Rum-da-rum-da-rum-da-do-da-rum-da-diddy-a-dee-da-do. Everybody sing, here we go. Thank you very much. Now, do we have oxygen here? Let's see here. I love the bagpipes. Any bagpipe fans besides me?
My brother's a piper.
Oh, wonderful. Does he play a pipe band and all that?
Sioux Falls, Dakota District.
Okay.
Pipes and drum. He's the pipe master.
Oh, he's the pipe master. Wow, nice. I love those things. I do. Do you like, are you a fan?
Yeah.
Yeah, me too.
I never have to be.
That's right. That's right. They still understand that.
Yeah,
yeah. They're a wonderful instrument. I just get goosebumps when I hear the things. So I'm going to do a song about the pipes here. Now the Celts didn't invent the pipes. We think the, you know, we always think of the Celts and the pipes, but the truth be told, the Egyptians and Greeks and Romans were using the pipes back in 2500 BC, and then the Celts invaded some centuries later, and they discovered the bagpipes and had kind of this love affair with the thing ever since. And I think probably what really got them was the fact that this is designed to scare the bejesus out of your enemies as you're just coming over the hill. And I've learned it'll do the same thing to your neighbors when you're trying to learn how to play one, too. Anyway, this tune, if you listen close, you'll hear some pipes in there. I have a little studio at my home, and I record different instruments, and I can put them in this pedal and just carry them with me. So this is what we have here. This is called the Piper. Thank you. I've never done that with choreography before, but I like it. Let's see here. And I'm sorry, what is your videotaping this for a local TV station?
Yeah, SMU Channel 3.
SMU Channel 3, and what is your name?
Cheryl.
Cheryl, nice to meet you. What are the chances of you and I getting together after the show and editing out all the mistakes? Can we do that? It'll only take us a couple hours, probably. Thank you. And there will be, so I'm trying some new material, so it's always interesting. I can screw up the old stuff too, don't get me wrong, but new stuff particularly is interesting. There's a subculture in Ireland called the Travellers. The Travellers are a group of Irish nomads, basically, that were uprooted when Oliver Cromwell was the Lord and Protector of England, and he put forth some cruel policies towards the Irish. And about 1650, somewhere in there, they tried to move the Irish Catholics to the northern part of Ireland. And they moved some people off their ancestral homelands, lands that they'd lived on, they and their families, for centuries. But a certain sect of that group never did settle down after that. They took up a gypsy lifestyle, sort of like the Romanian gypsies, and they are called gypsies also, but I think they prefer travelers. Anyway, let's see if I can find this for us. This is for them. It is called Gypsies. See here. We'll leave that for a minute. We're going to try an experiment here. Oops. Not used to working with two guitars on stage. You probably figured that out. This is a guitar that my wife bought me some years ago, and I never played it. So she said, "Well, if you're not going to play it, let's sell it." And I thought, "Well, I want to do that, so I'll play it." But the problem is that I don't play in standard tuning often. I play mostly in what we call in guitar lingo alternate tunings. And I probably got a dozen different ones that I work in where I retune the guitar. And the reason I do it is because a lot of the music I play was not written for the guitar, but rather for instruments like the fiddle and the pipes and the harp. And these alternate tunings are just more accommodating to some of those older melodies, so I use a lot of them. However, this guitar I've got tuned to standard, so you don't have to sit and listen to me retune to standard. And as I said, I never play in it anymore, so tonight we're going to revisit standard for a moment here. Worked out a few things here. I realize that when people come to see me, some come because they like the guitar, some come because they like Celtic music, some come because of both. And then some people don't want to come at all with the wife or the husband. Sister, and here you sit. Listen to this, what is it, Celtic music, isn't that? So, bless your hearts for you that don't care for the Celtic stuff. Here's what I hope will work for you.
Tune for popular music, but that was Celtic music?
No, that was not.
Oh, okay.
No, that was just me indulging myself in a Beatles tune because I've got this guitar that I wanted. It's a long story, but no, it's not Celtic. Not for a moment. Now back to the Celtic. See what tuning I'm in now, figure out what we're gonna do next. Okay, so I found this kind of interesting. The Celtic word for oak is drew, and the Celtic word for knowledge is wit. So, put them together, you get Druid, and the Druids were, how shall I say, the sophisticated class of Celtic culture. They were the philosophers, the scientists, the mathematicians, so on and so forth. And they had a working knowledge of astronomy. And with that, they would hold many of their ceremonies in very specific phases of the moon, I am told, because they believed that it would give these ceremonies extra power, extra potency, in bringing about whatever they were trying to accomplish, whether it would be a full harvest or success in battle, any number of things. So this song speaks to this. This is called Druid Moon. My career has gone from saloon to salon, I think is a way to say, nice way to say it. Started out in the saloon, wound up in the salon, this being the salon and this being my preference by a long shot. The audiences are like this, they're lovely. And when you play in the saloon, you play a different repertoire than you do when you play in the salon. So, that said, I'm going to pull up one of the old songs from the saloon days, and if you should happen to recognize it, not that anybody here has ever been in a saloon, I'm sure you have not, I'm sure you haven't, but you might have been walking by when they were singing this song, recognize it, and want to sing out. Please sing out if you recognize it. bird high in the morning. Wait up, she rises. Wait up, she rises. Wait up, she rises her high in the morning. Put him in a longboat till he's sober. Put him in a longboat till he's sober. Put him in a longboat till he's sober. We're high in the morning. Shave his belly with a rusty razor. Shave his belly with a rusty razor. Shave his belly with a rusty razor. We're high in the morning. Anybody got any verses for this thing that I need to know about? Any really cool ones that we won't get shut down for or anything? No? If not for the courage of the fearless crew, the minnow would be lost. See, I drive a lot, and you get bored. You wonder what would happen if you put Drunken Sailor and Gilligan's Island together. Now we're going to find out. Oh, sit right back and you'll hear a tale of a fateful trip that happened from this troubling part aboard this tiny ship. Now the mate was a mighty sailing man and the skipper brave and sure, but they were drunk as a couple of skunks the day they gave that tour, that 3-hour tour. That's where they stuck on Gilligan's Island, that's where they stuck on Gilligan's Island, that's where they stuck on Gilligan's Island, or lie in the morning. No phone, no food, no motor car, not a single luxury. No Wi-Fi, no internet, no satellite TV. But you drink too if fate stuck you on that uncharted isle. Sing it out with Gilligan, the skipper too, the millionaire and his wife, the movie star, the professor and Mary Ann. Wait up, she rises. Wait up, she rises. Wait up, she rises or lie in the morning. That's what you do with a drunken sailor. That's what you do with a drunken sailor. What you do with a drunken sailor. Thank you for those who were bold enough to sing along with me. Gonna do a lovely old Irish air. This thing's been around for a few centuries. It's called Down by the Sally Gardens, and it's often played on the Irish harp, this lovely instrument that we almost lost at a certain point in history. What had happened was, back in the 1600s, it became fashionable for all the English nobility to have an Irish harper on staff to play for their gatherings. It was quite a status symbol. But they began to worry about whether or not these Irish harpers were actually spies for the Irish resistance. So panic kind of set in. Queen Elizabeth issued a decree that said, hang all Irish harpers wherever found and destroy their instruments. The people that were playing the harp just kind of quit. A lot of them took up the saxophone for a while. Jazz clubs started popping up. Well, no, that's not right. But anyway, so this is this lovely tune. I'll just do a little bit of it for you. Called Down by the Sally Gardens. Thank you. have guitar players here tonight? Anybody want to admit to that? Couple? Yes, sir. Do you play, what do you like to play? What's your, give your choice.
I like Todd Snyder. Todd Snyder songs. One of them is called, what is the name of that song? I'm having a brain fart.
Did you get that on the tape?
We'll have to edit that.
I'll tell you what, after I'm done playing, you'll have thought of it, and you'll come up and we'll talk shop, okay?
Okay.
All right. What kind of guitar do you like to, what kind of guitar do you have?
It's an Alvarez acoustic.
Oh, nice. Onboard electronics or not?
It does have electronics in it.
Okay, wonderful. Those are nice. I like those. You, sir, raised your hand back there. Yes, sir. What do you like to play?
Just maybe rock, and I like some bluegrass school.
Yep.
Stuff like that.
So do you play the electric and acoustic? Or?
Yes, and then I play the mandolin as well.
Oh, nice. So you play with bluegrass bands and stuff like that. I love bluegrass. Oh, God, I love that stuff. Have you played, how long have you been playing?
The guitar I've been playing for almost 20 years.
20 years, yeah.
Yeah.
So you know what you're doing.
Yeah.
I've been playing 6 weeks, and it's going well. Nice to meet you. I like to talk to guitar players, find out what kind of gear they like, what they're playing, and try to learn things, you know. It's fun to talk shop. And so you've been playing 20 years, so you started playing pretty young.
Yeah.
I was 15. And I had won $50 in a bingo game, and I thought, well, that's a lot of serious money, and I want to invest it wisely, so I'll either buy a bike or a guitar, I thought. And I pondered it for a while, and then I thought, well, my older brother had gotten a guitar about a year ago, and after that it seemed to me like he had a lot more girlfriends. So I thought, that's the way we will go. So I get this guitar, not this guitar, but another guitar, and it didn't help, but still, the thing was, I loved playing it, I loved the music, so I just stuck with it all these years, and someday I'll probably get a job, but not anytime soon. We learned at that time, it was 1965, we learned a lot of Beatles songs and played a lot of those. And then I quit playing them all together, got involved in country music and moved to Nashville and wrote songs and all that. But anyway, now I'm coming back and I'm listening to the Beatles, and I hear in their music a lot of Celtic influence. Makes sense because they're from a part of the world that was built on Celtic foundations there. And I really do notice it in some of their stuff, not all their stuff, but one like this here. This is written by John Lennon and Paul McCartney, and I think this could have very easily been a Celtic air. It had been written 300 years ago or whatever. It's called Norwegian Wood. Thank you. much. Now, if you will indulge me, I am going to retune here a bit.
Can't Complain is the name of that song.
And who's that by?
Todd Snyder.
Oh, Todd Snyder? I'm not familiar with Todd Snyder very much, so I don't.
Yeah.
Cool song though.
Yeah, he's a good artist.
Do you yodel in it or anything like that?
No, I think so.
So I used D'Addario guitar strings. Now these strings I've used over the last 20 years, and they're pretty durable. Don't break a lot of them. They can break, but for all the retuning I do, you'd think I'd break a lot more. And I get them for free because one evening, by chance, I was doing a concert and I mentioned, while I was tuning, because when you tune, you're always looking for something to talk about. And I mentioned that I used D'Addario strings and I was very pleased with them. I said they were durable and they had great tone, so on and so forth. Anyway, after the concert, a guy comes up to me and he says, listen, I'm a sales rep with D'Addario and you've done such a nice advertisement for our product. I think I can offer you an endorsement deal. All you'll have to do is tell people in all your concerts that you use our strings and that you love them. So I use their strings and I love them. Tonight, I'd like to talk about those new Honda CRVs for just a few minutes. I should have this in tune in another 30, 40 minutes, and I think we're very get in there now. I think that'll work. So I'm gonna do an old Irish jig, and this is a jig. So that is to say, it is meant to be danced to. So for those of you who have been waiting all evening to come up and dance, our dancer, I think, has left, or she's left. Anyway, for those of you who would like to get up and dance, this would be a great chance. Form lines here and here, don't crowd. And just come up and show us what you got. We'd love to see it's gonna be on video. It'll be on your local TV station. I'm sure you like that. And, what else can I tell you? If nobody comes up, that's okay too. No pressure to come up, but if not, I will start picking people at random. So please, for my point, just be ready if you wouldn't move it along. This one goes back to the 1700s. It's called Merrily Kiss the Quaker. Thank you. years ago, I was I was invited to come down to Hastings, Nebraska, perform for the 100th anniversary of St. Cecilia's Chapel, this old chapel that they're so very proud of, and rightfully so. And they said, when you come, would you write like something lively, like a reel that would bring some joy and more joy into this? So I said, sure. So I went down for the 100th anniversary, wrote this thing, and played it for them. And it went very well. In fact, they've invited me back now for the 200th anniversary of St. Cecilia's. So maybe we could route that through here, Robin, and get this. So anyway, I wrote this for him and call it Cecilia's Bells. Golden, Colorado. And has anybody heard of Golden, Colorado? You've heard of Golden, Colorado.
Yeah.
It's not that obscure. For the main course of beer?
Golden, Colorado.
Colorado School of Mines, but who cares about that? We've got beer. Rocky Mountain spring water and all that stuff. Well, we have a theater company there, and this theater company hires me every now and then to come if they want me to write a song or something they're doing. And so just wrote this for them, have not performed it before, and just, if you'll indulge me, I'm just going to take it for a little test run with you. Getting all this tuning, I hope we are. Sometimes I'll just do a show of nothing but tuning. If I get enough tuning enthusiasts, that's what I do.
What kind of strings are they?
Cheap? No.
Mm.
Sharpie there. So I wrote this for our little studio trip there in Golden, Colorado. Written a few things for them. And this is a, I guess they're doing a vaudeville kind of a thing. And so this is called Soft Shoe, I guess, for my friends in Golden. Let's see here. I should do that. All right. Thank you. you one more, and before I go, just want to thank you for taking a little time out of your day to come out and listen. I appreciate it so much, and always great to be with library audiences, as I say. I do have CDs over here on this table. About five different ones, I believe. I got one called Keepsake that was my first. And it's kind of a mellow album. If you're going to have dinner guests over and you don't want any fistfights to break out, it's really nice for that. Then I've got one called Fields and Fences, which was nominated for Instrumental Album of the Year by the Independent Acoustic Music Association. And it was one of five finalists, but it didn't win. However, it does have three songs that have been used in a forklift safety film. So, and that's a sure. And I got a Christmas album, and I got a couple more albums over there, and all that. And I'd love for you to take one if you're so inclined. And Robin, thanks so much for letting me come and perform in your library. This has been a great treat for me. Thank you. This lovely, lovely audience that we haven't had to call security one time. A few months ago, I was invited to come to Greensburg, Kansas. A town that had been blown off the map in 2007 by an F5 tornado. And they're rebuilding it now. And I admire them so much. And they built a state-of-the-art theater. They say it's the greenest community in America. And this theater is amazing. And they brought all their school kids in and had me play Celtic music and stuff for them and bore them tears for an hour. They just wanted to have them listen to something they don't normally listen to, so there I was. And I would play a little bit, and then I'd ask if there were any questions and stuff. No hands came up. Towards the end, though, a little boy had his hand up in the back, and I said, yes, what is it? And he says, can I go pee? And so that was about all I got from him there. But I learned this to them for them. Hopefully it would be something that they would maybe be familiar with that would involve. This tune to me is kind of a fusion of Celtic and Spanish music, and it's part of what really captured me about the tune. And it's from Pirates of the Caribbean, that Disney movie. So I haven't played this for a while, so hopefully we'll remember this. If not, we'll get together later and edit it right on out of the first. This is called He's a Pirate. And if you've seen the movie, you might know the tune.